Welcome back to the Make It Better series, a series where we take one weapon from Elden Ring and we stack it out to make it the best it can possibly be. So let me know what you guys think down in the comments, and today we are looking at the Flowing Curve Sword. This is a really unique weapon considering there's only one that you can get in the game within the Consecrated Snowfields, and it has the most unique R2 in the entire game. If you hold the R2 down, it will slash 3 times in a flowing sword dance, and if you just tap it, it will hit twice. I've paired the Sword Dance Ash of War with this because when you hit the R2 and then Sword Dance, they both flow very well into each other. That being said, you do need to stack poise like a crazy person, because if you get knocked out of this, it's going to be completely useless. So for talismans, I'm using the Shard of Alexander, the Bull Goat's Talisman, the Axe Talisman, and either the Rotwing Sword Insignia or the Millicent's Prosthesis. For buffs, I'm using Exalted Flesh and the Commander's Standard. For my flask, I'm going to be using the Opaline Bubble Tier and the Thorny Crack Tier. And after all that, you should have plus 30% physical damage, plus 20% damage negation, plus 15% skill damage, plus 33% poise, plus 26% charge attack power, and plus 33% attack power boost.